This phone was released by Fujitsu in 2011 in Japan. It runs two operating systems, Symbian and Windows 7. Not Windows Phone 7, Windows 7 Home Edition Service Pack 1, the 32-bit version. The CPU inside is an x86 Intel Atom. This is a phone and a laptop, all in one. The question is, why does this even exist? At the time this was released, most reviews puzzled over what this phone was intended for. Questions were raised about the design choices that were made. I particularly like this one from Gizmodo titled, "Horrible Idea, Nightmare Phone Runs Windows 7." Fujitsu themselves described this as a concept phone. Strange concept devices are not unusual, such as this Fujitsu Android phone with transparent display and touch interface on both sides. These things only exist in the sense that usually manufacturers make a few prototypes and that's it. The question then becomes, why was this self-described concept phone ever put into production? I can only speculate at this point. Going beyond the basic idea that it was just an ill-conceived design, I've seen some interesting and plausible explanations, such as this was specially designed for a large enterprise customer with a very specific need. This phone becomes much more usable when paired with the dock, which adds four USB ports and an HDMI output, transforming the phone into a more common desktop experience. I can see how having a dock at work and another dock at home could make this more usable. When you add the ability to carry that same computer in your pocket to use at any time, that would be a killer function in some applications. Though, bizarrely, when this was released as a consumer device, the dock was not included. It was only available as an optional accessory at considerable extra cost. That means if you find one of these second-hand, there's a fair chance it won't include the dock. Fortunately, I did get the dock with this one. Two further advantages of using the dock are that the CPU runs faster at 1.2 GHz instead of 600 MHz in handheld mode. And there is a fan in the dock to keep the phone cool. This phone can get quite hot when running Windows. The CPU inside is an Atom Z600. Intel developed this CPU specifically for phones and tablets. But as far as I can tell, this is the only product to have ever used this CPU. Intel did make and demonstrate some prototype handhelds using this CPU. It's an extremely low power CPU with a thermal design power rating of only 1.3 watts. The maximum RAM the CPU can address is 1 GB, which is how much memory this phone has. The main storage is a 32 GB eMMC based solid state drive. I want to put this phone through its paces running Windows. I'm going to load software using the microSD card slot. I have some software on this 32 GB microSD card. The card slot is located under the battery cover, and the battery needs to be removed to access it. Once installed, the card can also be accessed by plugging into another computer using a micro-USB cable. This is slightly more convenient, but not much, because the microSD card can only be accessed over USB when using Symbian. If Windows is running or on standby in the background, then that can't be used. Windows can only access the microSD card using some special software. Also, when in Windows, you can't use the GPS, Bluetooth, or the cameras, but you can use the Wi-Fi. While in Symbian mode, you can't access the Wi-Fi. This phone is kind of weird. It's like two separate devices jammed together. I suspect the Symbian side runs on a separate ARM CPU, with limited connections for interfacing to Windows on the Intel Atom CPU side. I'm now going to do some benchmarking to get an idea of performance. This will also include a thermal test to see how hot this gets. This won't be a reference test, I just want to get an idea of CPU and heat performance. I'm using the legacy benchmark software, PC Mark 7, for Windows 7. I ran the test and it took about an hour at 600 MHz, with a final result of 223 in PC Mark 7. This is a very low spec for Windows 7. I also wanted to test while running at 1.2 GHz. Instead of using the dock, I manually overclocked the CPU. I used the overclock instructions on the Snow Akami blog and tested the result with CPU-Z, and sure enough, it's running at 1.2 GHz. That way I avoided cooling from the fan running in the dock, so I could compare thermal performance. In both cases, with an ambient temperature of about 19 degrees Celsius, the phone's housing reached about 30 degrees Celsius, with the 1.2 GHz test reaching perhaps a couple of degrees higher. The phone felt warm, but not uncomfortably warm. In warmer environments, this phone will probably get too hot to use handheld. At 1.2 GHz, PC Mark 7 scored 360, which helps make the docked experience slightly better. The thermal and CPU tests revealed another limitation as a handheld computer. With light use, Windows can maybe run for about 2 hours on a single charge. Running Windows hard with the second-hand battery, I got about half an hour. Also, with the USB charging plugged in, the battery still went flat after a couple of hours when stress testing, because the USB can't supply enough power to charge and run the phone continuously in Windows mode. When in the dock, which can supply much more power, this shouldn't be a problem, and you can run continuously. So what can I do with such an underspecced machine? The Intel Atom and onboard GPU was not intended for 3D graphics performance. For testing this, I'm running the 3D Mark 03 benchmark from 2003. Some tests run okay, with what looks like fairly decent frame rate, while other tests in the benchmark really seem to struggle. With all this in mind, I decided to install a game from 2001, Star Trek Voyager Elite Force.
Welcome to Voyager Elcar's menu system.
Running the game, I get a decent enough frame rate, and it's almost playable, even with the awkward tiny controls. The important part is I get to explore the starship Voyager. Now, if I can just find the bridge, or engineering, even sickbay. Hopefully I get to bump into 7 of 9. There is another piece of software I want to run, and that's Dremels. Probably the best screensaver and animated desktop ever made for Windows. Seeing this running on here makes all this worthwhile. If you enjoyed this video, please consider sharing. I'd love to hear any comments. And if you like my channel, have a look at my Patreon. Subscribing to Patreon gets you access to early releases and bonus content and really helps the channel. Thank you for watching.